What's up, friends? So, teaching lessons and on break for lunch and started flipping through Facebook like everybody does. And I was just like, man, everything's so negative on here today. There's so much negative stuff on Facebook today. And it was just really overwhelming. And so I was like, you know what? I'm going to stop this and pull up my Bible and get the Word of God for a little bit while I'm on break. I did, and I actually came across a passage from Colossians 3:15 that says, "And let the peace of God rule in your hearts, to which also ye are called in one body, and be ye thankful. And it made me think about, there was a devotional book that I had, and I'd read it a couple years ago, and I still have it. I pull it every once in a while. That's called Sparkling Gems, and it's Rick Renner. It's a really cool, it's a big, huge book. But it's got some cool stuff in it, and I remembered it had this little, like a daily passage. And this is what it says, and I can't go top my head, so I'm going to read it for you. Have you ever had one of those days when there was so much confusion whirling around your head that you felt like screaming, stop? Yes. From time to time, everyone has that kind of day. And when you do, your temptation is probably either to get in the flesh and react to someone in an ugly way, or get depressed, go to bed, forget about it all. However, you know that neither choice will help you solve the problems you're facing. Rather than throw in the towel and give away to these emotions that want to get the best of you, why not stop right now and make the decision to let the Word of God rule you today? And when I say rule you, I'm talking about God's supernatural peace dominating and governing every emotion and situation that confronts you. If you don't make this decision, follow through with it, worry, fear, insecurity, doubt, and a whole other host of emotions will assuredly try to take control. And there is no worse roller coaster ride than when you're being knocked all over the place by emotions that are out of control. Instead, let the peace of God rule in your heart, as Paul wrote in Colossians 3:15. He said, "And let the peace of God rule in your hearts, to the which also ye are called in one body, and be ye thankful." And especially once you notice the word rule in this verse. It is from the Greek word brebo, which is, I have no clue if I'm saying that right, but which in ancient times was used to describe the umpire or referee who moderated and judged the athletic competitions that were so popular in the ancient world. Paul uses this word to tell us that the peace of God can work like an umpire or referee in our hearts, minds, and emotions. When detrimental emotions attempt to exert control over us or try to throw us into an emotional frenzy, we can stop it from happening by making the choice to let God's peace rise up from deep inside us like an umpire or a referee to moderate our emotions. As we do, we will be kept under the control of that divine peace as it rules our hearts. When this divine umpire called peace steps into the game, it suddenly begins to call the shots and make all decisions instead of fretfulness, anxiety, and worry. Galatians 3:15 could be translated, "Let the peace of God call the shots in your life," or "Let the peace of God be the umpire in your life and actions." Also, "Let the peace of God act as a referee in your emotions and your decisions." Even though it's true that everyone has hard days and difficult weeks, you don't have to surrender to those emotions that try to steal your joy, disturb your relationships, and rob you of your victory. When you feel overwhelmed by problems or emotions that are hitting you from every direction, just stop a moment and deliberately set your heart and mind on Jesus and the Word of God. As you do this, the wonderful, conquering, dominating, supernatural peace of God will rise up from your spirit and take control. And that's what I did today. Things were a little crazy. It was a crazy morning and all this stuff. So I kind of said, you know what, get in the Word. And I did. And I really like this. It's a great book if you ever look for it somewhere. But that's it. Rick Renner. Sparkling Gems from the Greek Studies. It's amazing. He also ends every one of these devotions, daily devotionals, with a prayer and confession. So he has a prayer. It says, "Lord, I don't want to let my emotions get the best of me today. So I ask that your peace would rise up like a mighty umpire and referee in my heart, mind, and emotions. Help me recognize those moments when unhelpful emotions try to sneak up on me. I ask you to teach me how to put those emotions aside and release your supernatural peace as resident in my heart. The peace that is always ready at every moment to moderate every thought and emotion that tries to pass my life. I pray this in Jesus' name. And it's a wonderful prayer. I really, I love this. It's a great book. And you can do some questions, but that's it. I just kind of was like, hey, you know what? That's a great one. I'm going to share it today. Try to get in the word a little bit today. Get out of Facebook. I'm getting ready to go back to teach and stuff. So, but have a blessed day. We'll talk to you guys soon. Peace.